excited to be able to give you some updates from our banquet this past month. It was an amazing time, and not only are we very encouraged to let you know that we brought in about $63,000, that's with donations and some in-kind services, but just to say that it really filled our emotional banks as a team to see everybody in the room and so many people in the community that are passionate about this fight with us and coming alongside to support us. Also, I'm super excited because October is a big month here at Lighthouse for Life. We are fully anticipating being able to begin moving into the Harbor property by the end of this month, and that's a huge part thanks to your prayers, your encouragement, and your support. So pray that all of the details come together and that can become a reality, and that very soon that property that we've been renovating will actually become a place where survivors can come and get their hope and their needs met. You know, when I think of October, I do have another day that comes to mind that I'm sure you guys do too, and that's Halloween. Halloween can be a wonderful time of people getting together to celebrate, trick-or-treat, candy, and of course costumes, where you get to put on a different identity for one night. But as we think about that in the context of human trafficking, we just want to give you a few things to consider as you anticipate that evening this year. First, think of safety. Safety may be something that's already on your radar, but just a couple things to consider. One, always have eyes on your kid. Even if it's in a church parking lot and there's a trunk or treat going on, make sure that you know where your kids are. Two, make sure that you can recognize them with the disguises that they have on. The last thing we need is some cute little ghost being exchanged by some cute other little ghost because you can't see the person that's underneath and you think you're leaving with your kid, but it's actually not your kid. And then three, make sure that the candy that they have has been processed by a manufacturer and is in a closed wrapper by the end of the night, just to make sure that somebody's not slipping something in that they're not supposed to. The second thing to consider when we think about Halloween is that this is actually a great opportunity for you to start having conversation with your kids about the realities of human trafficking. Because while you might be wearing a disguise for one night, traffickers are often wearing a disguise every day, and on our ongoing basis are tricking their kids, our community's kids, into a world that they don't want to be a part of. So what a great way for you to start to unpack what some of those disguises are. What is the difference between a healthy person and somebody who's pretending to be a healthy person? Here's just two things that you consider, okay? First, what's the difference between a secret and a surprise? Kids need to know that if somebody is telling them that they are not allowed to share information about their relationship or about their happenings with safe people in their lives, that that's not okay. It's an automatic red flag that this is not a healthy person. Secondly, if anybody is pressuring a child to do something that they are not comfortable doing, then that is not okay. So what may start off as a healthy thing but then turns into, hey, just do it to earn a little bit of money because of XYZ, or it's okay to leave your family because it's going to help you fulfill your dreams, but the kid's not comfortable about it, whatever that ask is, tell them that gut response of I'm not exactly comfortable with this is a huge red flag that they need to come talk to a safe adult about that. There are many other ways that traffickers disguise themselves, and that's partly why we exist, is to help you know how to help your kids. So if you'd like us to come and help you with those conversations, please feel free to reach out. And the last thing I want to say about this event at the end of this month this year is that it's a time where we like to pretend scare people, where we like to, plan our fears a little bit. But fear is a big issue for a lot of people on an ongoing basis all the time. They live in a state of, I don't know what the future holds or where the safety in my life lies. So if you could just join us in being in prayer for the many people in our communities that fear is not just a fun thing that is played around with on Halloween, but it's a reality in their lives, as you're anticipating getting ready for this event, then I think we can raise up God's warriors to also come alongside the survivors that we serve. So thank you for joining us at Lighthouse for Life, and let us know if there's anything we can do for you.